So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hoon Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the latest videos and other things. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is a very important question guys, because it talks about Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, the third venture, the third edition. So you have to consider these statements regarding PMKVY 3.0 and you have to identify the correct statement. So let's discuss about this guys, Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana 3.0, the third edition. But before moving on to the third edition, let us discuss about the first two editions. So the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, which is PMKVY in short, was launched in the year 2015. Okay, 2015 mein launch hua tha on the World Youth Skills Day. Now you have to tell me when is the World Youth Skills Day observed, write down in the comments. So it was launched in the year 2015. It's phase 1. Alright, phase 1 jo tha iska Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana ka 2015 mein launch hua tha with an objective to upgrade the skills of candidates in our country, of youth in our country. And it is the basic objective guys of this Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana is to provide short term skill courses. Okay, short term skill courses isme diye jate hain to the candidates. So remember this, short term skill courses, and it is implemented by National Skill Development Corporation, which is of course an organization under the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, which is currently headed by Mr. Mahendranath Pandey. Mahendranath Pandey's Lok Sabha constituency guys is in Chandoli, which is of course in Uttar Pradesh. All right, and moving ahead with the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, so during the phase 1, 19.85 lakh candidates were trained. All right, 19.85 lakh candidates ko trained kiya gaya tha during the phase 1. Now after this, in the year 2016, PMKVY 2.0, the second edition was launched for a period starting from 2016 up to 2020 with the of course same objective ke saath. And under this, 1.2 crore candidates were trained. And now this Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, the third edition, has been launched, which is aimed at supporting the local economy. Ab ye local economy ke upar local economy ko support karne ke liye this third edition has been launched, and it will be guys implemented in a more decentralized structure with more support and with more responsibilities of states and UTs. And the district skill committees, the district skill committee will play a key role in providing the skills to the youth of our country through the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana 3.0, and it will also address the skill gap and assess the demand at the district level. So there will be a major role of the district skill committee, and as already told by the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, Dr. Mahendranath Pandey, he said that this time the scheme will be implemented in a more decentralized structure. All right, and there are some targets also. So this scheme, the third edition, has a target to train 8 lakh candidates over a period of 2020-21, yani ki ek saal ke andar 8 lakh candidates ko train kiya jayega under this edition. And it has been launched across the country in almost all the districts, 717 districts mein isko launch kiya gaya hai. And it also has a budgetary outlay of 948.90 crore. And guys, it may increase or decrease in the future, but currently government said that it is a budgetary outlay of 948.90 crores. And remember one more thing here, that during the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana 2.0, the total budgetary outlay was 12,000 crore. Alright, and now 948.90 crore has been assigned for the implementation of third edition of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. Okay, and now let's come back to the question guys. I hope you can easily answer this question now. So you have to identify the correct statements. It will be implemented in a more centralized structure. So that is not centralized, that is decentralized structure, which means this statement is incorrect. It has a target to train 10 lakh candidates. So no, 10 lakh candidates ka target nahi hai. It has a target to train 8 lakh candidates over a period of 2020-21. And total outlay for this scheme is 948.90 crores. So this is correct, and we have to identify the correct statement, and we have only one statement which is correct here. Okay, so we have one statement which is correct here and which is not in the option. So let's say this option C is only 3. Option C is only 3. So option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. So guys, make a correction in the option number C. Let us say it is only 3. So therefore, option C, only 3 will be the correct answer. All right. And now let's move on to the next question, which is question number 2. Which ministry has got Scotch Challenger Award for transparency in governance? कौन सी मिनिस्ट्री को स्कॉच चैलेंजर अवार्ड मिला है फॉर ट्रांसपेरेंसी इन गवर्नेंस फॉर शुड बी देयर फॉर ट्रांसपेरेंसी इन गवर्नेंस सो टू मिनिस्ट्रीज गाइस हैज गॉट द स्कॉच चैलेंजर अवार्ड वन इज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स एंड अदर इज द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पंचायती राज वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट लेटर सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ ट्राइबल अफेयर्स फर्स्ट सो दिस मिनिस्ट्री हैज गॉट दिस अवार्ड फॉर ई गवर्नेंस फॉर आईटी लेड इनिशिएटिव इसको ई गवर्नेंस के लिए मिला है फॉर देयर आईटी लेड इनिशिएटिव फॉर एग्जाम्पल In the tribal ministry, tribal affairs ministry, all the scholarship schemes have been digitalized as per the direct benefit transfer mission mandate. 13 schemes are there on the ministry dashboard. 6 initiatives are on the Prayas PMO dashboard. Okay, इसी के तरीके से और भी कई सारे ऐसे projects हैं, IT led initiatives हैं for which Ministry of Tribal Affairs has got this award. Other than this, they have a Swasthya portal to present health and nutritional status of the tribal people across the country. Okay. And other than this, guys, they also have got 3 gold medals for their 3 initiatives, different 3 initiatives. Like, for example, they have a initiative which is known as Ice Stupa initiative. Now, what is this initiative? This, guys, it is implemented in Ladakh region. Ladakh region, we implemented it for solving the water-related problem. So, this Ice Stupa has got the gold award. Then, Swasthya portal, which provides the health and nutritional status of the tribal people. And then, there is a performance dashboard which is known as Empowering Tribals Transforming India. It has also got the gold award in the Scotch Challenger Award. Alright. And now moving ahead to the Ministry of Panchayati Raj. So this ministry has got this award for the transparency in governance. Governance mein transparency lane ke liye, they have got this award. And there are various initiatives guys of Ministry of Panchayati Raj. Like very recently Swamitva scheme was launched. E-Gram Swaraj for providing all the government services to the citizens, online monitoring systems for the Central Financial Commission funds flow and their proper utilization. Then we have audit online for online auditing of the Gram Panchayat. Then Service Plus, this is again for providing e-services to the citizens. And then we have Gram Manchitra, which is of course geospatial planning application. All right. So these are some initiatives of Ministry of Panchayati Raj. And of course, Ministry of Panchayati Raj is headed by Narendra Singh Tomar. His Lok Sabha constituency is Morena. And Morena, we all know, is in Madhya Pradesh. Narendra Singh Tomar is also the Minister of Rural Development. He is also the Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. And he is also the Minister of Food Processing Industry. Alright. And what about Ministry of Tribal Affairs? It is headed by Mr. Arjun Singh Munda. His Lok Sabha constituency is Khunti. And we all know Khunti is in Jharkhand. And Khunti is the birthplace of the great Birsa Munda. Okay. And now let's come back to the question, which ministry has got this award for transparency in governance? So as we have discussed, it's Ministry of Panchayati Raj which has got this award for transparency in governance, while the Ministry of Tribal Affairs has got this award for e-governance. All right. And Ministry of Minority Affairs, it is headed by Mr. Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. He is a Rajya Sabha MP from Jharkhand. All right. He is a Rajya Sabha MP from Jharkhand. Ministry of Finance, we always headed by Nirmala Sitaraman. She is also the Rajya Sabha MP from Karnataka. And Ministry of Education, guys, is Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank from Haridwar. Okay. And now let's move on to question number 3. Which of the following campaign has been launched by Petroleum Conservation Research Association, which is an organization under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas? And who is the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas? It's Dharmendra Pradhan. All right. And so this campaign has been launched by Petroleum Conservation Research Association. And why this campaign has been launched? To spread mass awareness about using the cleaner fuels. Cleaner fuels ke use ko badhane ke liye, mass awareness ke liye, this campaign has been launched. So you have to name the campaign. Okay. So guys, the name of the campaign is what? Saksham. And there is a full form of Saksham also. You have to remember the full form also, which is Sanrakshan Shamta Mahotsav. Sanrakshan Shamta Mahotsav. Sanrakshan means conservation, Shamta means ability, and Mahotsav means festival, or you can say the campaign. Okay. So it was launched by Petroleum Conservation Research Association, which is a body under the Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. And why it has been launched? To convince the consumers to switch to the cleaner fuels and for the efficient use of fossil fuels. How they can use fossil fuels more efficiently. Okay. And under this campaign, guys, there are various activities, like there will be, farmer seminars, farmers webinars होंगे, इसमें seminars होंगे, painting competition होंगे, through which mass awareness will be generated about using the cleaner fuels. Okay, and the very important thing is that this campaign will also spread awareness about the 7 key indicators which are essential for the adaptation of cleaner fuels in our country. And guys, these 7 key indicators or the drivers were quoted by Prime Minister during his one of the speech. Okay, and which are these 7 key drivers? Moving towards a gas-based economy, cleaner use of fossil fuels. Of course, you don't have to remember all these. These are just for the basic understanding. Greater reliance on domestic sources to drive biofuels. Achieving renewable targets with the set deadlines. And I hope you all remember the renewable energy targets. That's 175 gigawatt by 2022 and 450 gigawatt by the year 2030. All right. Increased use of electric vehicles to decarbonize mobility. Increased use of cleaner fuels like hydrogen and digital innovation across all energy systems. So these are the 7 key drivers which are essential for the clean energy ecosystem of our country. Okay. And there was an MOU that was also signed during the event between PCRA, which is Petroleum Conservation Research Association, and Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL, which is the implementing agency for two of the government schemes, which are Ujala and SLNP. Ujala and SNLP, Street Lighting National Program. And why this MOU has been signed? For the energy efficient PNG stove. Now, what is this PNG? Piped natural gas. Can you tell me piped natural gas, PNG stove ke efficient use ke liye, this MOU has been signed between PCRA and EESL. All right. So this was about this news, guys, and I hope you can easily answer the question. This question now, which of the following campaign? So the campaign is what? Option B, Saksham. Okay, Saksham here is the correct answer. Okay. And now let's move on to, guys, question number 4. Which organization has released Adaptation Gap Report 2020, which estimates the annual cost of adaptation to the effects of climate change? Now, what does this line mean? Annual cost of adaptation to the effects of climate change. What is the meaning of this? So this is the cost that the developing countries, that all the countries in fact, are paying to combat the climate change. जो climate change का असर हो रहा है हमारी दुनिया पे, उसके लिए जो हमें cost pay करनी पड़ रही है, उसको combat करने के लिए जो हमें cost pay करने पड़ रही है, that is the cost of adaptation to the effects of climate change. And this report, guys, Adaptation Gap Report, has been launched by United Nation Environment Program. Okay, United Nation Environment Program has released this Adaptation Gap Report 2020. And of course, what is the purpose of this report? To estimate the annual cost of adaptation to the effects of climate change. And according to this report, इसमें एक ही fact है जो आपको याद रखना है, that is the most important fact, that for the developing countries, the annual cost of adaptation to the effect of climate change will be quadrupled by the year 2050. 2050 तक जो वो annual cost of adaptation है, वो चार गुना हो जाएगा, it will become 4 times, which is currently around 70 billion, which is approximately 5 lakh crore. And it will increase to US$140 to $300 billion by the year 2030, while it will increase to $280 to $500 billion by the year 2050. All right. So this was about this news, and you have to tell which organization has released this report. So that's option C, UNEP, United Nations Environment Program. And of course, it is headquartered in Nairobi, which is the capital of Kenya. And who is the chief of UNEP? It's Inger Andersen. Inger Andersen is the chief of United Nations Environment Program. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye. Take care. And God bless.